From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Good evening. Welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. A Portland man died from a stab wound to the chest, and police say that no one is in custody. The stabbing occurred at an apartment complex behind a commercial area of Forest Avenue Monday night. Police say 47-year-old Carlos Ramos was a resident of 991 Forest Avenue. They say he was stabbed in his apartment and transported to Maine Medical Center, where he died. Neighbors say the victim lived in an apartment number 4 with his girlfriend.
Fighting all the time, drinking and fighting.
I just come out to, you know, talk to some friends, give them some support. It's a terrible thing. And I knew Carlos. It's unbelievable.
Police say several people, including the victim's girlfriend, were questioned, and there have been no arrests and no one is in custody. Police say they would like to hear from anyone who has any information about this case. While officials say a Maine State Trooper shot and killed a sheriff's department dispatcher who killed another man earlier in the day. It happened Tuesday morning in Dover, Foxcroft. Police say 46-year-old Michael Curtis killed 53-year-old Udo Schneider outside the Hilltop Manor nursing home, where Schneider was a maintenance worker. Witnesses say that Curtis walked up to Schneider and confirmed his identity before shooting him repeatedly.
We do believe that the victim and the shooter knew each other. The extent of that relationship will be disclosed through our further investigation, but this was not a random act.
Obviously, this is an assisted living facility for elderly. Obviously, they understand that something has happened today, the full extent of that. They won't know, probably, but they do know that somebody that they thought of as family has passed. So that is as traumatic as if you lost a loved one.
Police say Curtis, who was a dispatcher with the Piscataquis County Sheriff's Department, then drove off in a pickup truck to the local fairground, where he was shot and killed by Trooper John Brown. He died at a hospital. A former state lawmaker accused of threatening a news photographer with a loaded gun pleaded not guilty today. 58-year-old Frederick Winto of Garland is charged with criminal threatening, reckless conduct, and carrying a concealed weapon. Police say he pulled a gun on a man in the parking lot of a Waterville Dunkin' Donuts back in May. Winto stepped down from the Maine House of Representatives in September. A former middle school teacher from Monmouth accused of having child porn was in court today. 55-year-old Christopher Brown pleaded not guilty. His attorney told us that the charges stem from about 10 pictures found on Brown's laptop. Brown is free on $3,000 bail. He can have no contact with children under the age of 16. His attorney says that Brown is also accused of stealing a school laptop and plans to plead not guilty to that charge as well. Well, the governor says a state task force has found $25 million in savings to help balance Maine's budget. The task force will present its recommendations to the Committee on Appropriations and Financial Affairs by the middle of next month. The state's finance commissioner, who heads up the 12-member bipartisan task force, says the proposed savings leave the state in better fiscal shape moving forward. Thanks for joining us on here on News 8 Now. Tracy Sable will be right back.